Hello and welcome. My name is Jan. Today I want to show you how you can create 2D reinforcement in ORPLAN. I already created a stripe foundation and a foundation for a column. I also created already the sections of the fundaments. At first you create the plan, then you mark where you want to have your sections, and after that you have to imagine what you will see when you cut through the element. I recommend you to make one drawing file for the plan, for the cross sections, and one for the reinforcement. At first we click on the button Reinforcing. The first position will be the mesh reinforcement for the section AA. You click on it, select Steer Up Closed, and put it in section AA. Please pay attention to the concrete cover. Now ORPLAN gives you the opportunity to choose the direction you want to put the mesh in your plan. I choose the upper view. Go to your plan and select Start and Endpoint. If it's not placed in your fundament, adjust it by choosing one of the three reference options. If you want, you can change the settings before you place the mesh, or you can also change it after you have placed it. Next, you create position 2, which will be the straight bar. I click the option per meter. With that, in my plan will be only one position for this kind of reinforcement. It's up to you what you want to select and for what you need it. At first I place two layer of four bars in the plan and I select which bar I want to see. I do the same on the other side. After placing, I label the bars. You can change the label to a horizontal or vertical view. For that, you need to click on lines, which are also horizontal or vertical. Now we put position 2 also in the section. Pay attention that you make sure to unhook the box for counting. You don't want that this bus gets counted, otherwise it can be later very expensive. That's why I recommend you to check always the settings. Select dot laying and put the bus at the upper and lower part of the mesh. If you have put it on the wrong side of the line, you can change it when you use Mirror without copy. When you have done that, you can label them. In case the space is not the same as in the plan, then unhook the box spacing and go to Custom Text and write the spacing you need. Next, we create position 3. That is a straight bar with two hooks. In the settings, you can change the length of the hooks. I choose here 30 centimeters. I quit all the follow menus and take position 3 out of section BB. Now I click on place bar shape and select that I want to have 10 bars in each direction in the fundament of the column. I choose again just one out of 10, which I want to see. To the end, I label them. I do the same in the section. At first, I unhook so that the bars gets not counted. Again, I select one which I want to see. After that, I choose the dot laying. Here you have to choose where you want to start and end. If needed, change the distance and other settings. To the end, label the position 3. Position 4 is the last position and has a L shape. It's used for the connection to the column. I created the L shape via freeforming. I put 4 bars on each side of the column and label them. After that, I do the same in the section. Again, I have to look to the settings. After placing, I label them as the other times before. To the end, I get from all positions the full scheme and place it under the sections and get them in order. I hope that it helped you to understand 2D reinforcing in ORPLAN. You can help me out when you like the video and subscribe to my channel. In this way, you can give me a small support. There will be more videos about ORPLAN, so see you next time.